Today's generation, lots of data has been generated in seconds. So the real challenge is how to use the data, make it meaningful insights from the data, so that it is going to be useful for the business in the decision making. So mostly the data scientist is the one who is employed to analyze the data with statistical techniques, which help the business in decision making. So next, we'll be seeing the today's agenda or the webinar. We'll be seeing the features of each tool and compared to use of each tool with respect to the industries and the comparative study. So go further. So there are three tools where the data science is going to use in the industry. They are R, SAS, and Python. So are you audible actually? Can you hear me? If yes, I'm going to continue further. So now the features of R. So first of all, what is an R? So R is open source software. That means it is available for everyone. It is used for doing all the statistic analytics based on S language. S language is developed by Chambers. So it is a program so that each and every user can modify the parts so that they are going to work properly. Example, Linux and R. So what does the closed or other software does? Like other software such as Adobe and MS Office, they are closed structure so that only the owner can modify the data and he can only insert, inspect and copy the data. And there are no real-time updates. So, and integrating with the other programs, R is a language so that it is available other high-efficient languages such as C, C++, and Fortran, and OS independence. It is available in each and every operating system such as Unix, Linux, Windows, and macOS, and free BSD. So, how we are going to give the commands in the R. So from starting, taking the data and printing the data, you'll be giving all the commands in this. So next, we're going to the SAS. So what does SAS mean? SAS means is a statistical analysis system, which has been designed by the SAS Institute for advanced analytics, predictive analytics, and business intelligence. So mostly, this uses two types of interfaces. One is a graphical interface and other is a non-graphical interface. The people who are not familiar with the coding and everything, they can go with the graphical interface. And who are familiar with the coding, they can go with the non-graphical interface. So you'll be getting the doubt how it is going to help the programmers. Let's see. So it is going to help the programmers in retrieving the data information from the warehouse and generate the reports. And it has an inbuilt statistical analytics functions, and it is also helps the business in planning and testing and making decisions in future. It is also useful for the app development and quality improvement and the data warehousing. So next, we're seeing the features of SAS. It has a millions of rows and thousands of columns. It has a built-in statistical functions and comprehensive data and time and handling functions. That is, we can collect the data from at any point of time. So no need to worry about that. So it can interact with the database and it can interact with the OS. So we can get the outputs in various formats such as CSV, PDF, and X format. So most of the large scale organizations use SAS in IT management and HR management, in financial management, in the business intelligence, customer relationship management, in some SOSA, etc. And actually the data which is stored in SAS is called as a table, and it is known as a data sets in the SAS. So mostly the procedure for the programming is a step-by-step procedure. So this is all about SAS. Let's go further to Python. So Python is a simple language. It's like reading in English. It's a pseudocode nature allows the programmers to understand it very easily and helps the programmers to concentrate only on the code rather than the algorithm. It is a high level language. That is, it reduces the complexity of the coding and it is easy to learn. And it is an open source software that is, it can be distributed with free of cost. And it is portable. It can run on any device. So next, you will be confused regarding what it is, R, Python, and SAS. And this is a study which has been conducted in 2014 by KD Nuggets that 49% of the users use R program and 85% use the Python and 36.4% uses SAS. So only 2% of the people use the whole of the three programs. So let's see what are the data scientists are using, and we will be comparing the pros and cons of each tool. So these are some of the statistics which we go on the website, and which are the tools preferred by the industry, such as telecom, corporate, consultancy, retail, marketing, health, and financial services. Mostly in the telecom sector, 45% R has been used, but compared to the SAS, which is 50%, which is in the financial sector. And the Python is equally used in each and every industry. So coming to the education point, mostly R has been used in the PhD level and is used in the bachelor's level, and the Python is used in all the three levels, in the bachelor's, master's, and the PhD. So it depends upon the individual to choose what are the software. So next, we'll be comparing the R versus Python and SAS. So first of all, availability. So R is an open source software. It is available for everyone, such as like at Python. And the SAS, it is a licensed software, so it is costly. So ease of learning. So R has a steepest learning curve. That is, we should know the technique to learn that. So like SAS, like Python. And it has a high learning curve and it has inbuilt coding so that we should learn. So data handling capabilities. All these softwares can handle huge amount of data and they can convert the data into meaningful insights. So capabilities. So mostly R is an advanced software among these. Python and SAS, it has huge package base. So advancements. Due to its open source in nature, R has advancements better when compared to the Python and SAS. So job scenario. So R is mostly used worldwide everywhere. So the job market is worldwide. So SAS, because of its closed environment and its security, it is used by the big companies and financial institutions and community and support. R has the biggest online community. Python is a decent online community. SAS, because it's a licensed software which we have to pay, so it has a good customer support. So next will be scaling rate of 1 to 5 of SAS, R, and Python, availability and the cost. Since SAS is costly, so we are given 3 out of 5, and R and Python are easy available for everyone, so we are given 5 for them. So ease of learning. SAS has been 5, R has been 2.5, and Python has been 3.5, because SAS has inbuilt coding structures and R and Python, they don't have, the user identify according to his needs. So data handling capabilities. So each and every software handle the huge amount of data. So that's why we have given 4 for each of them. So handling capabilities. So because R and Python are the open source software, so that you can access it and develop it according to the user. So they have given 4.5 and 4.5 compared to SAS, which is 3, because it's closed nature. And advancement in tools. R and SAS will be given 4.5 because of its and its scalability. So job scenario, mostly all of now are related to the R and the Python. So that's why they are given the focus. And the learning support will be Python will be 4.5, R will be, and SAS will be 2. So if you communicate everything, we'll be 28.5 for SAS and 31.5 for R and 34 for Python. So we'll be coming to the conclusion, we can't say which is the winner among these tools, because each and every tool has its own importance, depending upon the individual and how he chooses that. So if you want to go for banking or pharma industry, we can go for SAS. If your goal is to become a data scientist with no industry preference, then R is a tool for you. Python is a programming language which is used for web development and analytic capabilities. So Python should be learned after the SAS or R, depending about the two factors. So next, further will be continued by Akanksha.